Managing people is what the senior team does. Growing people, managing people, building people, builds loyalty for the organization. That's their key job. See, there was a time when I used to go out to the market and sell. And then there came a time when I never used to go out to the market and sell myself unless and until it is necessary. Even if it was necessary, even if it, if somebody would come up to me and say, sir, I need you to come along with me and this client is not agreeing to this and that. Most of the time I would say, look, I go there once. This client is going to come back to me twice. You will lose your importance in the organization as it is. So I would spend a lot of time. I would do a lot of role plays, mock calls. And I would probably teach him as to how he could, you know, manage the client. I would try and understand what has he been doing with the client, what were the talks that has gone in, and so on and so forth. But even then, if there is a gentleman who is devoting a lot of time in different departments and so on and so forth, a supervisor, a team leader, I would say an hour a day is the minimum that he should put in. And for that matter, a clean, fresh brain is important. So if his office starts at 8:30, at about 9:30 or 10, I expect that particular person to come at least 1 or 2 days to meet people who require handholding at least an hour before. He needs, there are points, there are tricks and techniques to make the other guy, the member of the team, feel important, which means I'll call him a day before, I'll fix up an appointment with him, I'll give him the time, I'll call him a day before and I'll tell him or send him an SMS or a WhatsApp and say, tomorrow we are meeting at 8:30, I hope you remember. Remind him, I'll write things down, you know, I'll probably write things that has been going in between him and me and the discussions that we are having, the instruction that I'm giving. We will share homeworks. I'll probably tell him to use a particular path and then see how does it go and then report back to me. If I am not the guy to handhold, then I'll find out somebody who can handhold him, probably from his team, who's been a senior, where there is no ego hassle. And there are other tricks and techniques of coaching and mentoring. I'll probably, for every small achievement that he makes, I'll probably praise him in public, worth a praise, of course, not unnecessarily praising, but worth a praise. I'll praise him in public to make sure that he understands that he's going into the right direction and that he feels more confident. And that's about it. So an hour a day is the bare minimum that he can put in. Because if you ask me, a team leader's job is to make people, is to manage people, is to build people. People make organization. And these people will always remain faithful to him. And you know, people don't work for companies. People work for people. That's not me saying, that's something that has been said for many years now, I guess. A lot of people have heard it. Few people may not have heard it, but it's the truth. I have never worked for an organization. I have worked for the person I am working with. I have worked for the team because I have worked for a lesser salary because the team is fantastic. Because my boss listens to me. Because I get to learn a lot from my senior. Because my boss is never my senior, my team leader is never impatient with me. He always takes out time and discusses things that are going right and going wrong and so on and so forth. So that's the answer. That's the answer I would give.